Most girls who see me for the first time don't like me. If only they spend some time with me and get to know me better, they start to truly hate me. I love my mother. She's a good mother. I tell everywhere she's a great mother. But she isn't satisfied. She says, I don't want to be a good mother or a great mother. Make me a grandmother. It's not easy for me to get married because I'm very bad at first impressions. Most girls who see me for the first time don't like me. If only they spend some time with me and get to know me better, they start to truly hate me. It happens all the time to me because I'm dark-skinned. People don't like dark-skinned people in our country. Forget others, my own parents. Like when I was born in the hospital, looking at me, their first reaction was, ayyo. They said it so loudly, half the hospital thought I was a girl. My mom spent more money on almond milk to rub on my skin and make it fairer than buffalo milk to feed me. I was just born dark. I grew up to be dark and malnourished. Like I'm a fully grown adult today, but my mom doesn't let me touch coffee or tea, saying drinking them will make me darker. People like my mom believe the color of what you eat affects the color of your skin. That's why South Indians are obsessed with eating everything in white. No matter the color of what you eat, the end result is still brown. Skin. But I can understand my parents' disappointment because in my family we have both genes. Because my grandfather was dark and rich. My grandmother was fair and poor. Now I am dark and poor. But we have the other branch of the family, my cousins, who inherited all the money and the fair genes. Oh, they make so much fun of me. Aray, Saikiran, you're such a lucky guy. Because you're dark. Unlike us, you can go out in the sun whenever you want. As if my skin doesn't burn. This is melanin, not Teflon. These fair-skinned morons think that if a cow stays in the sun for too long, it becomes a buffalo. But forget animals. Even gods cannot escape this discrimination in our country. You all know Lord Krishna. Krishna means dark. He is described in the Mahabharata as Neelameghashyama, which means as dark as the rain-filled cloud. Then why the hell do they show him everywhere to be sky blue in color? Like how colorblind do you have to be to confuse the color of the cloud with the color of the sky? That's why we can't predict rains in this country properly. If you remember TV Mahabharata, Lord Krishna was played by Nitish Bharadwaj, who was super fair. That's like Leonardo DiCaprio playing Nelson Mandela. Because we can't accept a hero can be dark-skinned. Why? We are just dark, not shady. I don't think Lord Krishna was really a thief. No. He was just the darkest child in Vrindavan. And everybody accused him only. Because all the stuff that was getting stolen were white eatables. But at least ancient India was a progressive time. Because in spite of all the propaganda, Lord Krishna was very lucky with the ladies. Not something I can claim to be. I recently read a report by .com. According to it, 71% of Indian women want their husbands to be fair-skinned. The rest 29% don't care about skin color. As long as the guy is rich. So in this country, to whitewash brown skin, you need black money. My face is red with anger. But you can't notice it because of my skin color. See, I know about these matrimonial sites, unfortunately. Because let's be honest, this face wasn't exactly manufactured anticipating the arrival of Tinder. The highest my parents aimed was .com. And I registered on that site some time back. And there I realized that the competition for Indian women is absolutely brutal. On these websites, for 100 men, there are barely 50 women. And NRIs take away the top 20 export quality girls. The next 20 go to the two I's of India. IITs and IIMs. Men like me don't stand a chance. So I clearly wrote in my profile, I may not be NRI or an IITian, but I'm healthy, I'm a vegetarian, and I do not smoke or drink, even coffee or tea. I thought many women will be impressed by someone like that. And I got 5 responses. Not from women, but from people requesting blood and organ donations. It was a bit painful, but I took the money and the fruity and registered myself on s*****.com. And I'm very proud to tell you, just a few weeks back, I completed 5 years as a fully paid member of s*****.com. Apparently, I'm the first person in the country to reach this milestone. So they sent me a congratulatory email. After 5 years on s*****.com, most men get into a committed relationship or commit suicide. So as a special gesture towards me, they gave me a free upgrade to the fresh faces section of second s*****.com. And there on that website, I saw all these familiar girls who 5 years ago rejected me, got married, had kids, got divorced, and again on this website, again rejecting me. Deja vu! They say I'm incompatible with their kids. If you agreed 5 years ago, that would have been my kid. I'm a manglik. Yeah. So before I can marry a girl, I have to marry a tree. Now the only thing more difficult than finding a girl these days is finding a tree. But you may say, but there are so many trees around, you can just marry it. It's not that simple. There are caste issues. I cannot just marry any creeper or croton. Like if you're a Marwadi, you have to marry a money plant. You're a Brahmin, you marry a touch me not. You're mixed caste, you have to marry a hybrid. So I was getting desperate, like because all my friends had girlfriends, they're taking them to all these parks to do naughty things behind the bushes. I was going to the same parks alone to do naughty things with the bushes. But my very good, loving mother, she anticipated this when my horoscope was written. So she started raising a plant in my house, hoping when the time comes, I can just marry it. But now my priest tells me, because the plant and I were raised in the same house by the same mother, we are like brother and sister and should not marry.